to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design and assemble a monkey wrench in SOLIDWORKS with this wooden handle. You can see here we will create each and every relation here. So let's see how to do it in SOLIDWORKS. Now we will sketch our first part, moving jaw. So let's start. Select right plane, sketch. Choose a line and draw from a line, horizontal line just passing through origin point. Up to here, exit. Better end with origin point. Now let's select line. Go back and draw a half circle. Then draw a vertical line. Then again draw a half circle. Then connect with this point. Now exit. Here select one center line. Connect with this point. Okay. Now let's assign dimension. 44 mm, 35 mm, and from this end 45 mm, and the center gap 23 mm, and this distance 10 mm. And make this radius 15 mm. Okay. Select this circle and this line, make relation tangent. Okay, now just drag it. Define this radius 5 mm. Okay, now select this line and this circle and this line and make relation tangent. Okay, and first delete this tangent because we want to make some. Okay, connect it here. Draw one center line up to this line, exit, and make relation. Select this line and this line, make relation collinear. Okay, now let's assign the distance from top 5 mm. Okay, now here we will make the relation. Select this line, circle, and this. Delete it. Delete this radius. Now tangent. Now it's defined. Okay. Now try to make the radius. Select 3-point arc and connect one end to this end and keep the radius 40 mm. Okay, and select this line, make as a construction line. Okay, this geometry is almost fully defined, so let's select extruded boss. Mid plane, select 24 mm. Okay. Now again choose right plane, sketch, normal. Select corner rectangle. Draw one rectangle and keep the height 52 mm and the width 20 mm. Select center line and draw one center line and make this center line 35 mm. Okay. Now select extruded boss. Choose 12 mm mid plane. Okay. Now you can see it here. This structure we want to do little modification. This tangent relation, delete it. Now let's assign this radius 15. Okay. Or delete this line and we will again make one more line select this point go back just extend the line, select 3-point arc, connect with this. Okay, now let's assign the radius 15 mm. Okay, now select this line and this line, now make relation tangent. Okay, now this is perfect, so just exit. Okay. Now again choose, now select both the bodies, make the material steel brushed finish and assign the color red. Okay, now we will make the third body, so choose right plane, sketch, normal. Now start from midpoint, select the line, come down and connect up to here. Now let's assign the distance. Assign gap 4.5 mm and this gap 6 mm. And assign the length 5 mm and the bottom length 3 mm. And the overall length 110 mm. And this length from this point 4.5 mm. Okay, select revolve boss base and choose this line as the axis. select OK. Now select this body and assign the material brushed steel. OK. Now select this face sketch and select this outer circle and click convert entities and choose helix and spiral. We want to create a path for spiral for thread. Choose constant, pitch and revolution constant, and keep pitch 3 mm, reverse direction and revolution 35 mm, degree 0 clockwise. OK, it's going up to the end. Select OK. Now select right plane, sketch, normal, and here we will create profile path for thread. Select corner rectangle, draw a rectangle and keep the dimension 1.5 mm by 1.5 mm. Select exit. Now select, go to here and select sweep cut. Now the profile selected. Now select this path. Now see, it is going to cut. OK. Now you can see the threads are created. This thread also assigned the same brushed finish. So this is the our body ready, and make the fillet 1 mm. Select this face, this face and this outer line. Okay, again we need fillet 1 mm, and this time fillet keep 10 mm. Select this end and another end. OK, and this fillet make red color. Again choose fillet, keep 1 mm. Select OK. OK, keep as it is. So this is our first part, moving jaw. Now we will save it. Save as, go to desktop, create new folder, select wrench. This is the first part of wrench. Open it and save as a moving jaw. Let's move for next part. Now we will make the second part of wrench, fixed jaw. Select right plane, sketch. Select a line and draw a line, just pass through origin point, go back and we want reverse direction, not this direction. Okay, this circle we want. Right plane, line. And connect with this point. OK, let's assign, select center line, exit, select this line and make vertical. Now let's make some dimension. 25 mm from this end to this end also. Okay. Delete this relation. It should not be parallel with this line, otherwise now see it's moving. Select this line and this circle. Now make relation tangent. The here also tangent. Okay, now this is the better relation. Now we will select line and connect with this line. Select this line and make relation construction geometry. Now select this line and this line and make relation collinear. Select this distance from here 5 mm. Okay, select this radius 15 mm, this distance 10 mm, and this radius 5 mm, and this radius make 12 mm. And the distance between these two points make 24 mm. Select OK. OK, this line is also tangent with this point. Now let's extrude it. Extrude up to choose mid plane 24 mm. Okay. Now select the body color defined first, defined brushed steel, and the color keeps red. Now select this top face, sketch normal, select center rectangle, and you can see it here, this origin point looking. So just draw a circle from origin point and keep the length, width and height 12 by 20 mm. Okay, and select extruded cut and choose up to next. Okay, see the throughout hole created. Now choose fillet, keep 10 mm and select two ends only. Okay, that's it. Now select this end, sketch normal, select corner rectangle, draw a rectangle up to here and this same rectangle up to this line and define the length 12 mm, and this is by default 15 mm. This length define 12 mm. And by default 15 mm. Okay, select extruded boss and extrude up to 76 mm downward. Okay, now select this face स्केच नॉर्मल, फर्स्ट सेलेक्ट सेंटर लाइन, नाउ सेलेक्ट कॉर्नर रेक्टेंगल, ओके, एंड मेक द लेंथ एंड एवरीथिंग 30 by 17 mm, ओके. फर्स्ट मेक रिलेशन सेंटर लाइन एंड दिस टू आउटर लाइन मेक रिलेशन सिमेट्रिक. सेलेक्ट दिस लाइन एंड दिस डाउनवर्ड लाइन मेक रिलेशन कोलिनियर, ओके. लेट एक्सट्रूड अप टू सरफेस एंड वी विल सेलेक्ट दिस एंड एज ए नेक्स्ट सरफेस, ओके. ओ बाय मिस्टेकन वी जस्ट डिलीट दिस रिलेशन, वी वॉन्ट टू एक्सट्रूड इट. सेलेक्ट अप टू सरफेस, सेलेक्ट दिस सरफेस, ओके. दैट्स इट, दिस इज वॉट वी वॉन्ट. नाउ सेलेक्ट राइट प्लेन स्केच नॉर्मल, फर्स्ट ड्रॉ ए सेंटर लाइन. सेलेक्ट अ लाइन एंड कनेक्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू एंड अप टू हियर एग्जिट. मे बी हियर टू लाइन्स क्रिएटेड, सो जस्ट डिलीट एक्स्ट्रा लाइन एंड डिफाइन द गैप बिटवीन दिस 15 mm, ओके. नाउ सेलेक्ट दिस ट्रायंगल मिरर अबाउट सेंटर लाइन, ओके, एंड सेलेक्ट एक्सट्रूडेड कट. वी वॉन्ट टू कट दिस पोर्शन, चूज मिड प्लेन. वी वॉन्ट टू कट थ्रू ऑल बोथ डायरेक्शन. नाउ अगेन चूज राइट प्लेन स्केच एज यूजुअल. फर्स्ट ड्रॉ अ सेंटर सेंटर लाइन, वर्टिकल सेंटर लाइन. नाउ सेलेक्ट कॉर्नर रेक्टेंगल एंड ड्रॉ वन कॉर्नर रेक्टेंगल एंड डिफाइन द लेंथ 36 mm एंड द हाइट 12 mm, ओके, एंड मेक वन रिलेशन सिमेट्रिक. दिस थ्री लाइन्स एंड सिमेट्रिक एंड असाइन द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम दिस लाइन टू हियर 50 mm, ओके. नाउ सेलेक्ट एक्सट्रूडेड कट, चूज मिड प्लेन. सी इज गोइंग टू कट बोथ डायरेक्शन, ओके. नाउ इट इज कट. नाउ सेलेक्ट दिस फेस स्केच एंड वी वॉन्ट टू मेक वन होल हियर. कीप द डायमीटर 16 mm and let cut it. Select extruded cut and choose up to next, not through all, up to next, okay. Now the holes created. Now we will assign the fillet for whole body. Select 1 mm, select this face. Remove this face, all the sharp edges. Actually we want to make fillet, so whatever possible you can do in one attempt. Select here this face and select here directly the faces. I आई थिंक द फेसेस ओके. नाउ अगेन चूज फिलेट 1 mm. आई थिंक नो नीड फेसेस, वी हैव टू सेलेक्ट वन बाय वन. Clear. Just try to select all the sharp edges. Okay. Now select this all edges and make the brushed machine. So this is the second part, move fix jaw. Now save this fix jaw. Desktop. And find our folder wrench and here save fixed jaw. Now let's go for the next part, handle. Now we are going to sketch third part, handle for wrench, wooden handle. So select the same right plane, sketch. First draw a center line. Vertical downwards a center line. Now let's start our geometry. Okay, now let's assign the dimensions and everything. From this line 4.5 mm and from this line 8 mm. Vertical length 25 mm and this length 5 mm and this length also 5 mm. Now this length from here 15 mm and this length from here 12.5 mm and this body length 8 mm inside. Okay, now make relation, select this line and this line collinear. And select this point and this point vertical. Okay, now assign the distance from this point 110 mm and the distance from here to this point 23 and from bottom it should be 73. This one make 25. Okay. And this end with origin point, keep 17.5 mm. Okay, now our geometry is fully defined. Select corner radius 2.4 mm and select this radius, this corner only. Okay, now our geometry is fully defined. Select revolve boss base. Okay, and assign the color. We will assign some wooden color. Select wood, polished ash. Okay, now we want to create thread inside this wooden body, so select this from inside face, select this face sketch and select this outer circle. Select convert entities and select helix and spiral. We want to create some spiral path. Choose pitch and revolution constant. Pitch keep 3 mm, reverse direction and revolution keep 22 mm, 0 degree clockwise. Okay, now select right plane and section view. Okay, now again choose right plane sketch normal and here we will define some profile. So choose corner radius, draw one rectangle here, corner rectangle 1.5 by 1.5 mm, and this is okay. Let's select swift cut. Profile selected. Now here choose the path. See, it's going to cut up to outside. Okay, now see, inside we created thread path. You can see it here easily. Just select section view, it's full. Now you can see it here, inside we created. Now choose chamfer, keep 2 mm and select this outer body. Okay, now select this face sketch normal and select hexagon, oh sorry, polygon, and create one hexagon. Okay, now select this hexagon and origin point and make vertical. It is important relation. Okay, now select extruded cut. Choose your flip side and cut up to 80 mm. See, we will get some shape. Okay, we want to make relation now. We will make one more relation. Select right plane, sketch normal, draw a center line. Draw a circle and keep the diameter of circle 50 mm and the distance from this line 25 minus 1.56. Okay, now select this line, convert entities, and here also select this outer line, convert entities. Choose stream entity, select this outer portion, unnecessary lines. Now this is our radius ready. Okay, now select revolve cut. select thin feature, unnecessary, we don't want thin feature. Now is going to cut it like this. Select OK. Now see this section cut. Polished beach. So this wooden handle is ready. So just save this wooden handle. We will see how to do in assembly. Save as wooden handle. Wooden handle. Now we will make the ring for this wooden handle and final knob at the end. So first let's make the knob. Now we will make the knob for wooden handle. So select same right plane sketch. Select center line. Draw one vertical center line downward direction. Select a line. And let's start from origin point. Go back. Draw a circle, then again go back here, draw here one more circle, then draw a vertical line and exit. Now let's assign this distance 9 mm, 15 mm. And this distance from here 12 mm. Make the radius 6 mm and this radius 2 mm. Okay, now we want to make some relation. Select this radius circle and this radius circle in same direction, horizontal. And this line and this circle vertical in same line. Okay, now assign this distance 3 mm and this gap 7.5 mm. Okay, choose one line and make one chamfer from this point to this point. Let assign the distance. Keep 8 mm and the degree keep 45 degree. Okay, select trim entity and trim these outer lines. Okay, and but make sure this distance 15 mm and assign this length 2 mm. After 45 it may be, might be 14 mm. Yeah, okay. Now select circle and draw one circle from and keep this point as a tangent. It is important relation. Now select this center point of circle and this point and make the center gap 11 mm. Okay, select trim entities, delete this half circle. Okay, select a line, connect from this end to this end. Sometime due to mouse error double line selected. Now our knob body is ready, so just revolve boss base. Okay, see it's created. And make the body chrome metal and assign satin finish chrome. Okay, this looks nice. Now here we will make some thread. So select this face sketch, select this outer circle, convert entities. Choose helix and spiral, pitch and revolution, constant pitch and pitch keep 2.5 mm and revolution 6.35, not all. Okay. Now again choose right plane, sketch, normal. Now here we will make some thread geometry. Draw one vertical. Connect from center line. Select this line as a construction geometry. Now make relation. Symmetric. And now keep the angle 60 degrees and the overall length 2.17 mm. Okay, select corner radius 0.15 mm, select okay. Now select this line and this line and make relation collinear. That's it. Okay. Now exit. Select sweep cut. Profile selected. Now choose this line as a path. See, it's going to cut this thread. Okay. See, it is. We cut the thread. So our knob is ready. This is the knob for wooden handle. But here we forget some design. Select our sketch. Normal. Choose circle and draw one circle with this point and keep the diameter 2 mm. Okay. And select trim entity, select half circle and inside lines. Okay, and make sure these two points vertical. Okay, exit. Now save this knob. Handle knob. Now let's make the last part, handle ring. Now we will make the last part of handle ring. For a wrench, select right plane, sketch. Draw a center line, vertical center line. Select corner rectangle. Okay, let assign the distance. Height keep 8 mm and the distance from 8 mm from one end and another end keep 12 mm. Okay, now select this line and origin point, make relation select this point and origin point, make relation horizontal. Okay, now select revolve boss base. Okay, assign the color yellow. Okay, so this is the ring for wooden handle. We will see how to assemble in SolidWorks. Select here and choose ring. Okay. Now let's go for assembly of wrench. Now we will start the assembly of wrench, monkey wrench. Select new assembly. Okay. Bring Browse our first part, fix Joe. By default, this part will be fixed. Let's set the our things, make quality high. And I prefer plain white background. Now insert next component, moving jaw. Select third component, wooden handle and knob. This both component we will bring together. Okay. Now let's make the relation. Choose mat. Clear. Select this inside face and this knob face. Make relation concentric. Okay. And make handle this portion and the knob back portion. Okay. Now the handle fixed. Now we will fix the handle. Select this inside and knob. Concentric relation. This body. Coincident. Okay. Now let's select this circle and this circle and make relation concentric. Okay. And here also we will make this face and this face keep parallel. Okay. Now see, it is going inside upward. Now we will create threads relation. Take it out. Go to mechanical mat, screw, and here select teeth. Select this face and this face. Distance, keep distance 3 mm. Reverse direction. Okay. Now let's see how to screw relation created or not. Just drag down. See the handle rotating. That means screw relation is created. See, screw relation is created. But we want to make some relation between these two faces. Choose advanced mat. Select this face. Select this face and this downward face. Minimum distance keep 1 mm and maximum 70 mm. Okay. Now see it's opening. Now see, this is maximum and this is minimum. So this is the relation we created between this maximum and minimum. The minimum gap 1 mm and the maximum opening 70 mm, not more than that. Even if you want reduce, just make 50 mm. Okay. Now it will open up to 50 and minimum 1. So this is the our monkey wrench. Actually this is a kind of monkey wrench. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe our channel for more projects in SolidWorks, and don't forget to share and like our video. Thanks for watching. We forget to add our last part, insert component, choose ring. select mat, select inside hole of this ring and this. Okay, now the back face of ring and the face of body coincident. Okay, now save. So this is our ring. I hope you enjoyed.